As Tesla FSD Beta V10.69.2.3 continues to roll out, Elon Musk hinted that V10.69.3 will have major upgrades. Elon Musk gave hints about some of the changes that FSD Beta might get with V10.69.3 on AI Day 2022. In response to questions from the audience, he talked about a specific update to the car's ability to figure out how fast traffic is moving. One FSD expert also said that Tesla plans to release a parking lot stack before the end of the year. Stick with us till the end to know more about it. Welcome to Techmo. Without any more delay, let's get to the video right away. Tesla AI Day 2022 is drawing near. As the date of AI Day draws nearer, Tesla may provide us with additional information regarding FSD Beta and reveal the date on which it will be made available to the general public. Tesla has been continuously releasing new variants of the FSD Beta 10.69 software for the past 30 days or so. Elon has previously stated that once version 10.69.2.1 is made available, drivers whose safety scores are greater than 80 will be eligible to participate in the FSD Beta. A blogger by the name of Gail Alfer stated that the most recent FSD Beta update for Tesla made her commute to work go off without a hitch. At this time, drivers of Tesla vehicles are required to have a safety score of 95. Because the score has reached 80, a greater number of Tesla owners will now be eligible to participate in the FSD Beta testing. This demonstrates that Tesla believes the software will continue to improve and mature over time. Elon informed owners who had previously achieved a perfect safety score about upcoming changes to the safety score before they received FSD Beta 10.2 last year. He stated that it would be improved again and again until it was able to predict collisions with a high degree of accuracy. Tesla recently provided attendees of the Hot Chips 34 conference with additional information regarding its Dojo supercomputer. One of the new things that was demonstrated was the instruction set for the Tesla Dojo. One more was a comprehensive investigation into the mathematical formats, system network, and software's capacity to navigate around inactive processing nodes of the supercomputer. As a result of Tesla's recent addition of 7360 A100 GPUs to its GPU supercomputer, the company is now ranked in the top 7 in terms of the total number of GPUs. Nevertheless, this is not sufficient. At this point, Dojo becomes relevant to the discussion. On AI Day of the previous year, Tesla announced that it was developing a supercomputer named Dojo, in which each node has its own CPU, memory, and way to communicate with other nodes. During the conference, Tesla's software engineers who worked on the Dojo supercomputer showed new architectural features, such as the Tesla Dojo instruction, for the very first time. During the conference, discussions were held regarding the arithmetic formats, the system network, and the capability of the software to route around dead processing nodes. According to Next Platform, one of the topics that we should anticipate being discussed at Tesla AI Day 2 is the efficiency with which the Dojo system operates. Emil Talps, who works at Tesla as an autopilot hardware engineer and worked at AMD for nearly 17 years on several Opteron processors, also gave a presentation at the Dojo. Our application's defining goal is scalability. We have de-emphasized several mechanisms found in standard CPUs, such as coherency, virtual memory, and global lookup directories, because they do not scale well when we scale up to a very large system. Instead, we relied on very fast and widely distributed SRAM storage across the mesh. And this is supported by interconnect speeds that are an order of magnitude faster than those found in a typical distributed system, Tom said at the end of his presentation. Also, if this is your first time watching us, make sure to click the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you can watch our future videos and stay up to date. Now getting back to the point. The second AI Day will take place in Palo Alto, California, and will also give Tesla a chance to talk directly to its FSD critics. After talking to a few FSD beta testers about 10.69.1, a pattern started to form. Testers kept bringing up the same problems. The top three problems that testers talked about were phantom braking, turning problems, and not being able to tell what the speed limit was. FSD Beta 10.69.2 seemed to have a lot of problems with picking lanes. Several FSD Beta testers said that their Tesla would use the turn lane even when they wanted to go straight. Right now, more drivers are getting Tesla FSD Beta 10.69.2.2. So far, testers seem to like the changes in V10.69 as a whole. Most of the testers who talked to Tesla Roddy said that V10.69 made FSD Beta a lot better. After installing FSD Beta 10.69, many beta testers said that they felt safer driving on residential streets. But some people are worried that FSD might not be ready to be used by more people by the end of the year. They think that FSD Beta is not ready for more drivers yet because it still needs to be closely watched. Musk said earlier this year that vehicles that qualify would be able to use FSD by the end of 2022. Earlier this month, he said that Tesla might put out supervised FSD. According to current FSD beta testers, Tesla's self-driving software has gotten a lot better since V10.69 came out. But many people think that Tesla should be more careful before letting more drivers use FSD. Tesla, keep working on it, but don't be so optimistic. One FSD beta tester said, "You can't drive on my roads if you don't have to step in." When Tesla lowered the safety score requirement from 90 to 80, the number of people in the FSD beta group in the US and Canada went up by 60%. About 160,000 Tesla owners have now signed for the program. This means that more FSD supporters are giving feedback on Twitter, which is Musk's preferred platform. Elon Musk is known for being too optimistic when he talks about FSD beta, but what he said about V10.69.2.2 is in line with what some longtime members of the program have said. Tesla seems to be trying very hard to get FSD into its fleet. Martin Vieca, Tesla's Senior Director of Investor Relations, recently said at a Goldman Sachs Tech Conference for invited guests that the company is on track to release supervised FSD by the end of the year. That's about how long Elon Musk says it will take for FSD to be widely used. Even if Tesla is able to get supervised FSD out to consumers by the end of the year, drivers would still need to pay attention to the road and drive safely even with this version of the advanced driver assist system. But if Teslas had a supervised FSD with all of its features, they could drive themselves on the highway or in the city. Lastly, this is a quality that will be very hard to beat. Chuck Cook, the man behind the famous Chuck's Corner, also known as the unprotected left turn, took the new FSD to his most tested spot. His YouTube videos are great, especially the ones about making an unprotected left turn, which show how his Tesla gets through a tricky spot from different camera angles. He sent out a tweet with a video of 10.69.2.2 flying through the area, which made Cook clap and say, "Wow, yes!" Musk, as you might expect, saw the video. At a recent meeting of shareholders, he talked about Cook and said that he appreciated the fair and honest criticism of the turn and that it would be fixed. The CEO said this in response to the video, "As we get better at using neural networks to predict the speed of cars crossing, the car will be able to move through gaps that are narrower. Next month, 10.69.3 will come out with a lot of improvements." Double N stands for neural networks, and Musk's answer shows that, even though Cook liked the system, he thinks it can and will do better. Someone on Twitter said, "FSD beta is great, but could the car turn its signal on before getting into the turn lane? It uses the signal to change lanes based on speed, but not to get into a lane for turning." The tweet got a lot of attention, and some people criticized the company for making its cars change lanes without signaling. Musk must have agreed because he just said yes and didn't say anything else. Owners of Teslas in Silicon Valley took to Twitter to ask, "When will Elon realize that traffic is moving more quickly and speed up the Tesla? It can sometimes be slow." Again, Musk quickly and clearly answered by tweeting, "Next month." We can only guess that this will also be part of the 10.69.3 release. Soon after AI Day, Teslas with FSD should be able to download this set of three improvements. While everyone waits for Optimus, the humanoid robot, to be shown to the world, Tesla owners will be interested to see what 10.69.3 brings to their cars. So that's all for today's video. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up. And if you want to watch more videos like this one, then hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you will always be notified.